of this. Catch up, catch up. Have you asked him to resign, Larry?
Sajid Javid, Health Secretary, resigned from personal matters. Said he would no longer give the Prime Minister one more chance. He repeatedly done so, he said, over lockdown parties and now over handling the allegations of corruption. Turned again to the issue of transport of the Commons, and the fact that ministers have repeatedly sent out to make statements about the Prime Minister. The Prime Minister knew about those allegations, but number 10 only to admit, actually, they weren't. Let's turn back to this issue of Rishi Patel, the Home Secretary. Story broken by The Times, there's a tweet from their Home Affairs editor saying Rishi Patel has sided with a group of cabinet ministers calling for Prime Minister Boris Johnson to go. The Home Secretary, one of Johnson's most loyal supporters, The Times says, believed there's no way he can continue to govern without the support of his party. Now, a while ago when I read that tweet, I said the BBC wasn't able to confirm it, but our political editor Chris Mason is now also saying, I'm told, the Home Secretary Chris Patel has told the Prime Minister he should resign. So we can say with some certainty now that the Home Secretary Chris Patel, extraordinary really when Boris Johnson stood by her when she was under pressure of bullying allegations, now saying the Prime Minister should go. Sky News' Beth Rigby, who's just on the side from me here, says Jacob Rees-Mogg has gone into number 10, although he clearly didn't go into the front door. And we're hearing from the Labour MP, Conor McGuinn, who says the government has had to cancel the bill commissions due to take place in Parliament tomorrow because they now don't have enough ministers to attend. So there is an awful lot going on. Let's take a moment to pause and consider what's played out in this extraordinary day. It was the morning after the resignations the night before. Health Secretary Sajid Javid had gone, so the Chancellor Rishi Sunak. And those reading the Daily Telegraph first thing on Wednesday saw a column by the former Cabinet Minister Paul Frost. In it, he said the Prime Minister should resign before chaos descends. And as we considered that morning, the new Chancellor, Nadeem Zahawi, went on the BBC's Today programme at 8 a.m. The problem is that for days, number 10's explanation hadn't been true. Well, the BBC's Chris Mason said various iterations of it have, it would seem, turned out to be dribble. Mr. Zahawi was asked about that issue. He was also asked about his approach to his new job. I will review everything. I will be the evidence-led Chancellor, Mr. Zahawi said. It wasn't clear if he was suggesting that perhaps that was a point of difference to how others had approached the job. Either way, while the Chancellor talked to the BBC, the resignations kept coming. Moments later, the same thing happened again. Pete Robinson informed Mr. Zahawi that Minister Bill Quince had now resigned. And then, at 10 past 10, MP Chris Skidmore posted a no confidence letter online, in which he wrote, "This is an extremely grave situation that is tantamount to an effective cover-up of sexual abuse that would never have been tolerated in any normal functioning workplace." Mr. Johnson denies a cover-up related to this picture, but through the morning the calls for him to go continued. At around 10 past 11, the MP Tom Hunt joined in.